We asked for and received some great questions about COVID from you today. We'll get to those in just a second. First of all, let's take a quick look at the numbers to set the stage. Where we are right now does look better. Remember, from a horrific starting point, but things are improving. You see right now, 42 states in green. Means heading in the right direction. Fewer COVID infections now than a week ago. 42 states trending down, 7 holding steady. Only Nebraska reporting more new infections now than a week ago. If you look at it this way, the case trend line, follow the red line. 53,000 plus, 53,883 new infections yesterday. It's a high number when you compare it to the beginning or even the summer peak. But if you've been through the horror of the winter, starting this trend line starting to go down now, finally. 53,000 starting to trend down. One reason is masking and social distancing. Another reason is there are vaccines now getting into arms. 70 million distributed to the states, just shy of 53 million, actually shots put in arms. So some progress being made here as the Biden administration takes over the vaccine rollout. If you look at the 7-day average of vaccines, again, back on January 20th, just before this graphic began, it's just shy of 900,000 a day. Now it's up to above 1.6 million vaccinations every day on a daily basis. The new administration trying to push that number up even higher. And if you look at it this way, 12% of Americans have received their first dose. Remember, the vaccines on the market now both require 2 doses. 12%, just shy of that, have their first dose, but only 4.3%, so shy of 5% of Americans have been fully vaccinated. That's why the challenge is there for the new president as he has his town hall tonight. Here's another way to look at it here. This is the percentage of the population with its first dose administered. Alaska setting the pace at 17%, West Virginia 14%. You see some 12s and 11s, some 10s. This is first dose. Most states now, I think every state, yes, just Rhode Island at 9%. All the other states in double digits in terms of a first dose. Now you're looking, what about vaccinated fully? That's when the numbers drop. People waiting for their second dose. Again, Alaska just shy of 8%, West Virginia just shy of 8%. Most states in the 3 to 5% range of people who have their first dose now waiting for their second dose. You want to get back to work, you want to get kids back to school, you want people to feel more safe moving about, restaurants open. These percentages have to jump up. Dr. Anthony Fauci says, we know it's coming. Be patient.
When you hear about how long it's going to take to get the overwhelming proportion of the population vaccinated, I don't think anybody disagrees that that's going to be well to the end of the summer and we get in the early fall. When are going to we be able to start on that process? It's probably going to be in the springtime because the whole process is going to take a few months to actually get implemented. We have a good plan how to get those doses into people's arms. We just need more vaccine.
With us to share her expertise and her insights, our CNN medical analyst, Dr. Lena Wen. She's also an emergency room physician at George Washington Hospital, a former Baltimore City Health Commissioner. Dr. Wen, I have some great questions from our viewers from Twitter, but let's first just start with what we heard from Dr. Fauci. It is hard to have an aircraft carrier do a tight U-turn. So we have to give the new administration some grace as they inherit this challenge. But do you see proof that they get it, that they are ramping this up in a way where the numbers from day to day are getting better at the pace that you find satisfactory?
Well, I definitely think that we're ramping up, and I like what I hear from the Biden administration, that they are clearly listening to the issues that states and locales are raising, the need for more resources, the need for predictability of supply, and they're trying to address each of these bottlenecks. I still think that they need to be aiming a lot higher. We need to be getting to the place of having 3 million vaccinations a day. That's what will allow us to get to some level of some chance of having herd immunity in 2021.
So let's get to these questions, and they're really great questions. This one's from Juan Abbas. Do you think it's possible for kids to be back to school late autumn in realistic terms, fully vaccinated and without masks?
Well, I think the first part, definitely. We definitely need to get kids back in school, fully back in school by the autumn. And I think there's a good chance of us doing that if we get a lot of adults, the majority of adults ideally vaccinated at that point. But children are probably not going to be vaccinated. Children above the age of 12, I hope, will be able to get the vaccine starting late summer, depending on the results of the clinical trials. Younger children may not be able to be vaccinated until late 2021. And so I do think that schools, when they come back in the fall, are still going to require masks, but we need to put in these mitigation measures. That's what will allow us, our kids, to get back in school and learn again.
Now, that's a great question. Thank you for the answer there. This is another great question from Lisa Riley. What transmission rates for communities do you consider safe for reopening schools?
So there isn't one number, and here's the reason. There are two factors that determine school safety. One is the level of community transmission, and the other is the level of mitigation measures that you have in place. So if you have a low level of transmission, you need some mitigation measures, but not everything. Versus if you have a very high level of transmission, masking, distancing, ventilation alone is not enough. Maybe you also need to reduce class sizes. Maybe you also critically need to make sure that teachers are vaccinated. So it really depends on the level of transmission. Then you also will add on additional mitigation measures depending on what that transmission rate in the community is.
Here's another great question I need to note. I'm at John King CNN on Twitter because this next gentleman took my preferred handle, at Dermeatloaf, on social media here. Here we go. How long does protection last? Are we going to need to get an annual vaccine for the foreseeable future? If so, how does that work with the rest of the world being far behind the United States in pace?
Well, we know that the vaccines that we have developed thus far, they last at least 3 months. They're probably going to last quite a bit longer than that, but we just can't say definitively because they are relatively new. As to whether we need regular boosters, probably. So we are seeing that there are vaccines that are, or these, that there are variants developing that may not be as susceptible with the vaccines that we currently have. And so it may be that we need to develop boosters that specifically target these variants. And it may be that we need to get an annual shot the way that we get for the flu. But I still think that this is terrific news because essentially we can turn COVID-19 from the severe disease that it is into something like the flu if we're able to get enough people vaccinated, because we know this vaccine provides people such extraordinary protection from severe disease and hospitalization and death.
That's an excellent point. One last question here. This is from at Sassy Dubs. There wasn't much research on elderly patients to study. After a few months of vaccinations, does the data show any issues for that age group?
It's a great question, and actually we have some preliminary results from Israel. There was a study that involved more than 1 million individuals who received, or half of them received the vaccine, half of them did not, and they actually found that in the real world that the efficacy of the Pfizer vaccine is duplicated based on what we're seeing in Israel. And critically, the effectiveness of the vaccine for older individuals over 70 appears to be about the same as the effectiveness in younger people, which is very highly effective. And this is very reassuring data.
Dr. Wen, thank you for your time and your patience going through. They were fascinating questions. I really appreciate your important insights, and I appreciate everybody for sending in the questions as well. We'll keep doing this. It's very helpful, and it's, we all learn as we go through it. Thank you, Dr. Wen.